Hi everyone, sorry about the previous live. That's what happens when you have lots and lots of duties to attend. But I have these 10 minutes for all of you out there preparing for your entrance examination. Again, a very, very happy Holi to all of you. So what is important is that you have a particular routine. Like for me, jab main apni entrance ke liye prepare kar rahi thi, to of course I padhai puri karni hoti hai because there's a lot of syllabus. Par usi beech mein I used to make sure ki my diet, my sleep and my exercise, three things are not affected. Now diet important isliye hai kyunki when you're getting the right vitamins, the right amount of carbs, your brain needs sugar. Brain can only live on glucose. So you know, at that point of time, you have to maintain a good diet because you need to feed your brain the right amount of food. The second thing is exercise. When you exercise, your body's output better. So instead of sitting in your room for 10 hours a day and not doing anything except for studying, it is better to divide your study time into small slots, and between those small slots, have small breaks. And in the breaks, you can do exercise, you can, you know, maybe listen to music, relax your mind. So ye sab cheeze aapko help karegi. Jaise ki main neurotransmitters ki baat kar rahi thi, to it's a very scientific reason and very simple explanation. Chemical hai jo ki aapke brain ko function karne, aapke jo nerve cells hain, brain cells hain, unko function karne ke liye help kar raha hai. And wo chemical thode time baad khatam ho jata hai. To agar aap lagatar padhte rahenge, to kuch ghanton baad jo aap padh rahe hain, uska koi asar hoga nahi itna zyada acha. Kyunki aapka neurotransmitter khatam ho gaya hai. So you can give your body a small break, whether you study 40 minutes, then 10 minutes break, then 40 minutes. So the 10-15 minutes break, you will make your neurotransmitters again the body, so you will study well in the next 40 minutes, you will remember that. So it is important to have small breaks in between, rather than studying for a continuous long period of time. दूसरी चीज है टेंशन नहीं लेना है, डोंट स्ट्रेस ड्यूरिंग एग्जामिनेशंस, हैव अ काम माइंड एंड स्टडी. सो सेजल हैज अ क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज हाउ मेनी आवर्स पर डे मस्ट बी स्टडी. नाउ दैट एब्सोल्युटली डिपेंड्स ऑन यू. टू बी ऑनेस्ट, देयर इज नो डेफिनेट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम ऑफ हाउ मच यू शुड स्टडी. यू शुड सी व्हाट वर्क्स फॉर यू. यू नो, सम पीपल रिक्वायर अ लॉट to read a thing again and again. Some people are able to do it in a less amount of time. So that you have to discover about yourself. That I cannot tell you. But how many hours you study, you need to keep certain amounts of break. The second thing, like I said, is to study smart. Now, what do you mean by studying smart? The first thing is, of course, to also have breaks, to exercise, to be able to do a little bit of, a little bit of your hobbies, like painting maybe and stuff. And you don't have to completely cut out from everything. Just make sure that you have a certain amount of discipline when you do something. So the third most, so study smart is actually, of course, you have to work hard. You cannot achieve anything in life without hard work. But in that hard work, if you're able to study smart, if you're able to focus on the things that are important. Now, how I use this was I studied the previous year question papers. So the last 20 years question papers should be on your tips for any entrance exam you're preparing, be it engineering or medical or even boards for that matter. So have all last 10 to 20 years question papers on your tips, because most of the questions are quite related and you'll come to know, you know, what is the pattern and what kind of topics are more common. So 80% of the question paper, the syllabus you'll be able to master. Second thing is, I was never the kind of a girl who would study every day. I used to also be the last moment studying kind of a person. But now, because I was able to do well in boards as well as in my entrance examination, was only because throughout my 12th grade, the whole 12th grade, I focused on preparing myself, on clearing my concepts and preparing myself for entrance. For boards, because I prepared myself for entrance, my concepts were clear. And the kind of language that is required for boards and a kind of pattern of answers that is required, I studied during the last 1 month. So a question hai, ओके ओके मयंक, तो मेरिट में आना दिक्कत होता है. Like I said, it's not rocket science. Of course, it's not easy. It is difficult, but it's not impossible to get a good score in either of the examinations. The thing is that, now another question is that a lot of people ask me is, which coaching institute should we join, or should we do homeschooling? You know, it doesn't really matter. I'll be very honest, it doesn't matter whether you're going to a coaching institute or not. Whether you know, which coaching institute you're going to, it doesn't matter. What matters is you and how you are studying. Alright, make sure that your concepts are clear, because if any question is from, you know, any question is unexpected, you're at least able to attempt it in a way. Now, once you keep solving the question papers, jo pichle jo NEET ke ya AIMS ke ya JEE ke jitne bhi purane question papers hai, agar aap unko revise karte rahenge, to aapko pata chalega ki, you know, ek jab time bahut kam hota hai entrance exam mein, so there is a certain sense of, you know, anxiety in your head. So guys, sometimes you miss out on certain questions and you're not able to answer them properly, or you know the answer, but at that moment in the exam, because of your mind, you're not able to focus on it. So that is it. So it's very important to practice question papers and time yourself, because I believe it's a 3-hour examination, so depending on that, you have to do it. Now, Vidya, did my sleeping patterns impact my studying? How many hours of sleep do we need? Now, that is also depends on individuals, but I ideally slept for 7 to 8 hours at least every day, because sleeping really, really helps your body function better, especially your brain. Your brain needs rest. And once your brain is rested, that is when you're able to study. Second thing is, I was never the late night studying person. I was more of an early morning studying person. And I feel early morning worked better for me, because when your body is fresh and your body wakes up, then your body is able to take maximum load on it. Your brain is fresh at that moment, and it's able to, you know, grasp. Us waqt aapka jo dimag hai, sabse zyada cheeze andar apne rakh sakta hai. So it is important to have proper sleep and at proper time. So I was an early to bed, early to rise up kind of person. Of course, I did have my late nights as well when I had an examination the next day, but that shouldn't be a routine. So at least I would say at least 11 hours of sleep is important. And yes, your sleeping pattern does impact your studying, because studying is all about your mind, and your mind requires rest. How to prepare for 11th? Well, it's 11th is like any other year of your school, because it's just I think for me, especially like, because I was preparing, I knew I was going to give my medical entrance, 11th was only about clearing my concepts, not about like my marks or my rank. How to concentrate and remember things. Now, one more very good thing to practice is meditation. And meditation doesn't mean that you're spending hours and hours, you know, in a corner of a room. But meditation would be, I used to wake up early in the morning, especially at this time when you have holidays, when you get prep leaves before your boards, utilize these holidays. So I used to wake up early in the morning and for 10 to 15 minutes just meditate. So when you meditate, your mind is able to focus on things. And you know, you're able to take decisions with a calm mind. So it's very important to stay calm at this. Is time pe aapko calm rehne ki zarurat hai. Aur uske baad, like maybe you can go for a morning walk in the park or something. So these kind of things, when you spend some time with nature, you're able to concentrate better. Second thing is, try to change your position. Like if I'm studying in one room, I used to get bored after a certain point of time and I used to not be able to concentrate. So maybe you can change your room, you know, you can change the environment, and stuff. And of course, take small breaks, because after a certain period of time, maybe an hour or 2 hours, you do lose concentration when you're studying. Hi, Heartless King, you have your board examinations, all the best, really, really do well. My cousin also has his boards starting soon. So just, I think for me, my stress buster were my hobbies. I used to either paint, I used to go to the gym, or you know, I used to listen to music. So just have small practices between your studying patterns, and to, you know, have small hobbies, have these certain activities which will help you reduce stress. Alright, so as I said, it is not rocket science to give an examination. Remember, millions of kids give this entrance examinations or are giving boards. So it is absolutely all right. All the best to all of you. And all I'd say is that it's all right even if it doesn't go according to how you planned it. You know, maybe there's something better in life. Maybe there's something better that's better task in life that's made for you waiting out there. But what is very important is to keep a calm mind, to divide your syllabus in a proper way, to do a lot of revision. So even if you're not able to properly study in the first go, if you keep revising, if you keep brushing on it again and again, it'll be very helpful. Like I did the past 20 years question papers at least 7-8 times. So I even remember the options that were. So I'm sorry about the pause, and that really helped me a lot. So keep revising again and again, and keep practicing as much as you can. Even if you feel that you've not read a topic, read the question. In case a question comes from a topic which is outside your syllabus, then go and read that and clear that particular concept. Because right now you do not have the time to read every single thing, but you can revise the important things and start solving questions. And when you solve questions, if a certain topic comes that you do not know about, then read about it. Yes, early morning studies are much better, according to me, but I mean, everyone has a different way of studying. So if you have less time, then though it is very, very important to just revise questions. At that point of time, it is better not to pick up the book and read every single line. What should you do for relaxation? The best way to relax is exercise. You can dance, you can go for a run, you can go to the gym, but exercising is the best way to relax during examinations because it makes you feel much better. जब मैं एक्सरसाइज करती हूँ तो मुझे बहुत खुशी होती है बिकॉज आपकी बॉडी एंडोर्फिन्स और एनकेफलिन्स रिलीज करते हैं जो कि हैप्पी हॉर्मोन्स होते हैं एंड दे मेक यू फील मोर हैप्पी एंड स्ट्रेस फ्री. सो आई थिंक ओके अरीशा, यू हैव बोथ एंड नीड टू, हाउ कैन यू मैनेज बोथ ऑफ देम? नाउ दिस इज हाउ आई डिड, because I scored a 95.5% in boards and then I cracked NEET in my first entrance and I got a very good government medical college. Now, for boards, what I did was, 11th, I will be very honest, 11th I was not more focused on the entrance. 11th was more on like I cleared my concepts and I studied from the NCRT. And then when I came to 12th I finished my syllabus really fast. So by the time I had my first pre-boards, that was probably around September, October, my entire syllabus for 12th was over. Now, once I was done with that, I started my 11th syllabus. Because you do tend to forget. It was 1 year ago. I revised my 11th. And for physics, chemistry, I strictly stuck to NCRT. For biology, of course, because it's a medical entrance, you do need to read extra. But after that, for 1 month before my boards examination, I completely forgot about the entrance. I only studied for boards, and it was easy for me because I मैंने पहले से concepts clear कर लिए थे अपने, and मुझे अब सिर्फ boards में एक pattern होता है. There are certain things because you need to write long answers, so the way of writing. So all of that I studied, and of course English and mathematics. I had PCMB, so English and mathematics I had not prepared for the entrance, so I had to study that. So that 1 month I focused on that, and then once I was done with my boards, I immediately, you have like at least a month to prepare for your entrance examination. So in that 1 month, I only did question papers. I first, and along with my question papers, I used to revise, I used to divide time. So like I used to divide, like I'll do 3 question papers today, or I'll do, depends on like how many, I don't remember the exact number, it was a long time ago. But I would divide my syllabus. And I said, okay, in 2 weeks, I need to complete this much of syllabus. Every day I would divide. I'd keep a timetable, a time slot with a lot of breaks in between. I'd do that syllabus and I'd solve those particular question papers. So every time you solve question papers, you become more quick and you realize that the pattern of questions is very similar every year. So I think now all of you off Instagram and back to your books, go to study now. And I did not go live earlier because I can understand it is night time in India, so you guys must be playing Holi before that. But I'm really happy to see that so many of you have still joined in my live video. All the best. It's it's okay. Just keep revising as much as you can. Have a calm mind. Exercise in between. Have a good diet. And just be happy. You know, there's no point taking stress and doing something. And everyone has their own way of doing it. But all I'd say is that just relax during this point of time. Do things that make you feel happy. And it is not impossible to crack any entrance examination. I also gave the JEE mains examination, and surprisingly, because I had not prepared anything, and maths I had hardly done 5-6 questions, but I cleared my JEE mains as well, because my physics and chemistry concepts were strong. So it is important to make your concepts strong and then practice as much as you can, because the more you practice, the better you'll be able to do it once you're there in the examination. So bye-bye. All the best, everyone, for your boards, for your entrances. And don't worry if things don't go the way you had planned them. It is absolutely all right, because life is full of surprises and you have nothing in this world that can stop you from achieving what you want to achieve. Bye-bye. Lots of love. And now go study.